the new type of radar that will detect low observable targets like stealth aircraft, and it is resistant against radar jamming. Answer is advanced quantum radar. The basic principle behind a quantum radar isn't overly complex in of itself. A traditional radar emits a beam of electromagnetic energy, which then reflects off objects in the distance, allowing the entire system to register their return signature and position with varying degrees of specification. A quantum radar does essentially the same thing, but using photons that are entangled together after a single beam of light is split in half. One of the two new beams passes through a converter that sends the particles traveling onward at a microwave frequency to bounce off objects like a normal radar. The full system would convert the particles back into the visible frequency as they returned to the radar's receiver. The second beam doesn't do much actively, but serves an immensely important purpose. A phenomenon called quantum entanglement means that the pairs of photons that appear at the point a beam of light is split otherwise have a tendency to operate identically regardless of how far they are apart. What this means is that the quantum radar should be able to register the paired photons in both streams and record only the signals it gets back from particles that have a partner. This would make the system more accurate since it would be able to quickly eliminate signals from other sources, such as ground clutter when tracking targets at low altitude or operating in a maritime role. In principle, this would also give a quantum radar the ability to immediately disregard outside radio frequency noise, make it far less vulnerable to traditional jamming, which often involves flooding the receiver with so many signals, or sending out false or misleading signals, that it is impossible to distinguish targets of interest. In the inverse, the photons may not necessarily trigger existing radar warning receivers on hostile aircraft, leaving their crew unaware that someone has detected and is tracking them. On top of these benefits, the quantum radar should be able to identify stealth planes, missiles, and ships. Existing radar absorbent materials are not specifically designed to absorb or diffuse these particles. Stealthy shapes might still deflect the photons and cause them to lose energy to some degree, but the system's ability to isolate only the activities of the entangled photons theoretically means that it should be able to detect even a very weak signal by cutting out all of the background noise. A network of quantum radars could provide an important defense against China's potential opponents, chiefly the United States. The US military is investing significant resources into stealth aircraft, such as the US Air Force's future B-21 radar and existing B-2 Spirit stealth bombers and the Tri-Service F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. The US military is also waking up to the need to improve its electronic warfare capabilities, with various systems, such as the US Navy's Next Generation Jammer, now in development. While photons experience quantum entanglement, they also suffer from a related phenomenon known as quantum decoherence. At extended ranges, the link between the particles becomes less pronounced and they may break free entirely, eliminating any potential benefits from recording the movements of the shared streams. At that point, the quantum radar is essentially just a normal radar using a different type of energy beam. Scientists have posited that the process of converting the one stream of photons to a microwave frequency would help prevent decoherence. Still, an operational quantum radar might need to be relatively large and have a significant power source in order to generate a beam of particles that is powerful enough to detect targets at extended distances. We have no way of knowing how large experimental prototype actually is. Size and power requirements also present challenges for low-frequency anti-stealth radars that China, Russia, and others have been exploring, as well. Those arrays are large and generally immobile. The technology is likely still years away from reaching a practical state. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.